Hi students, all of you, good morning. Welcome to the class. In the last two classes, we are discussing the competitive part. The chapter is polymers. And from your material, today we are going to discuss some MCQs regarding objective exercise 2 and objective exercise 3. And this is the class 3. And this is the final class regarding this objective exercise of polymers. Remaining bits you have to solve. If you didn't get the answers or if you are having any confusion, just you have to call me on my WhatsApp number 94902-83667. On this number only you have to text or you have to call. Don't call, don't message to the previous number, right? So today's topic is the question number, page number 143. Question number 28, page number 143, yes, page number 143, and the question number is 28, yes, read the question first. Which of the following is not true? Yes, this is the question given in the case set 2016. Case set 2016, previous year's question. Which of the following is not true? The first option, in vulcanization, the rubber becomes harder and stronger. Second option, natural rubber has trans configuration at every double bond. Third option, Buni S is a copolymer of butene and styrene. Fourth option, natural rubber is 1,4 polymer of isoprene. Yes, in the last class we discussed about natural rubber. What is the IUPAC name of natural rubber? The IUPAC name of natural rubber is cis 1,4 poly isoprene. Yesterday we observed the structure of the natural rubber. Between the carbon and carbon, just I am writing a simple thing, I am not writing complete one. Yesterday we observed this type of bonding in the natural rubber. These type of units are going to be repeated. How many times? N times. So if you see this carbon double bond carbon, on the same side, same type of groups are present. Hence it is an example of cis polymer. Natural rubber is an example of cis polymer. So the question asked this, which of the following is not true? So it is a cis polymer, but not a trans polymer. See the second option. Natural rubber has trans configuration at every double bond. That is not correct. At every double bond carbon, the natural rubber is having cis configuration, but not trans configuration. So the option is the second option. Question number 28. The option is second option. Important topic. That is important topic about rubbers. Two types of rubbers are there. Natural rubbers and synthetic rubbers. You have to go through the different types of questions regarding natural rubbers and synthetic rubbers. Next, question number 29. Question number 29. Yes, once again, read the question. Identify the monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubbers. Monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubber. Monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubber. please see the textbook. If you are having the textbooks, please open the topic, synthetic rubbers topic. In the textbook, if you see the synthetic rubbers topic, there you can find the examples. First one is neoprene. Neoprene. Second example given is Buna N, capital N. And the third example is Buna S. So these three are the examples of synthetic rubbers. Now the question is, question number 29. Identify the monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubber. Suppose if you take Buna S or Buna N, either in the Buna S or in the Buna N, one thing is common. What is the common thing? One of the monomer unit is common. What is the common monomer of these two? The common monomer of Buna N and Buna S is 1,3-butadiene. 1,3-butadiene. That is represented as CH2 double bond C, single bond CH3, single bond CH, double bond CH2. This is the representation of 1,3-butadiene. If this was represented in the form of bond line structure, skeletal structure, then we can write carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are in the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are in the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons. Between first and second carbon, double bond is present. First carbon and second carbon, double bond is present. Second carbon is having methyl group. Single bond CH3 is represented like this. If a single bond is there in the branch, that single bond is indicating methyl group acting as the substitute. So this is the methyl group acting as a substitute. Remaining is between the third carbon and fourth carbon. This is the third carbon and this is the fourth carbon. Again, a double bond is present. So once again, if you read the question, question number 29, identify the monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubber. So what is the one of the monomer used in the preparation of synthetic rubber means? 1,3-butadiene. It is a common monomer in Buna S and Buna N. This is the structure and it is the complete structure. Yes, take the screenshot. Otherwise, while watching to the recorded video, just press on the pause button, take the screenshot, write it in the notes. Important topic, rubbers. Rubbers is an important topic for CET and NEET. Right, moving to the next one. Biodegradable polymers. After the question number 29. Okay, wait a minute. Question number 30. See the question number 30 and read it. Question number 30. Read the question. Question number 30. Actually, here, this is a different type of question. Generally, it is known as assertion and reasoning type of question. Assertion and reasoning type of question. Here, assertion means capital A, that is, a statement is going to be given. A statement is going to be given. A means assertion. In the assertion part, a statement is going to be given. And in the R part means a reason part, some one more statement is going to be given. Here in the reason part, the statement given, if it is correct for statement A, then we go for option 1. If the statement is correct and the reason given is correct, but the reason is not going to explain the statement, then we go for option 2. Otherwise, if only statement is correct and the reason is not a correct statement, then we go for option 3. And simultaneously, the fourth option is, if the statement given is wrong and the reason, in the reason the statement given is true, then we go for option number 4. That is, statement is wrong, but the reason given is the correct statement. So there are 4 types of options are there. First option, both assertion and reasoning is correct, and reasoning is the correct explanation for assertion. Second option is assertion, the statement given is correct, but the reason is not correctly explaining the assertion. So like that, different options are there. Yes, read the question 30. A means assertion. Natural rubber becomes stiffer by the vulcanization with rubber. Sorry, by the vulcanization with sulfur. Yes, first of all, we are taking a natural rubber. We are taking a natural rubber. Rubbers are coming from the latex of rubber trees. Latex of rubber trees. From the latex of rubber trees, we are getting the natural rubber. The natural rubbers are very soft. Very soft. But we are using rubber tires for the vehicles. But the rubber tires are not hard. Sorry, the rubber tires are not soft. The rubber tires are hard. So making the rubber hardening by heating with sulfur. By heating with sulfur. So whenever to the natural rubber, that is a soft rubber, is taken, if sulfur is added, then what is going to happen means the physical properties of rubber is going to be enhanced. Then the obtained rubber is called as, the obtained rubber is known as vulcanized rubbers. So vulcanized rubbers are hard in nature. So in the vehicle industries, in the transport industries, to make the rubbers, to make the tires, natural rubbers are not used, because the tires will get destroyed easily if you use a natural rubber. That's why the natural rubbers are heated with sulfur. Then the obtained rubbers are called as vulcanized rubbers. So in the textbook, again, you can find the same thing. In the rubbers part, vulcanization of rubber. That is an important topic. Yes. Now we are seeing the options. Assertion given is, natural rubber becomes stiff by the vulcanization with sulfur. Reason, sulfur forms cross links at the reactive sites of double bonds in the vulcanization process. My dear students, already I said that when a natural rubber is taken, what is meant by natural rubber? Cis 1,4 poly isoprene. Once again, natural rubber is nothing but cis 1,4 poly isoprene. Between carbon and carbon, what is there? Double bond is there. So if one layer of rubber is taken, suppose if it is the one layer of natural rubber, if it is the second layer of natural rubber, between the one layer to another layer, between one layer to another layer, what is going to happen means cross linkings. This link is called as a cross link between one layer of rubber to second layer of rubber. So here the sulfur, which is used acting as a cross linking agent. So because of the cross linking of natural rubbers with sulfur, then we are getting a hard rubber that is named as vulcanized rubber. Now read the statements. Assertion, rubber, natural rubber becomes stiff by the vulcanization with sulfur. Yes, that is a correct statement. Next, reasoning. Sulfur forms cross links at the reactive sites of double bonds in the vulcanization. Yes, reasoning is also correct. So here the given assertion is correct and the reason is correct. Now we go for the option. What is the option here? Option is 1. important concept it is. Next, moving to the biodegradable polymers. Biodegradable polymers. Biodegradable polymers. My dear students, all of you know the polythene covers. Polythene covers. All we are using the polythene covers. We are all using the polythene covers. Whether the polythene covers can get degraded in the soil. Once again, my question: can the polythene covers will get degraded easily in the soil? Whether they get decomposed easily in the soil? So polythene covers are not easily getting degraded in the soil, and they are causing to the pollution to the soil. The polythene covers which are getting decomposed in the soil, they are causing pollution to the soil. Whereas some polymers are there, when these polymers are subjected to biological systems. For example, if any polymer which is thrown in the atmosphere is containing bacteria. The atmosphere is containing the bacteria. With the help of bacteria, that means with the help of, with the use of biological species. With the help of biological species, for example, with the help of bacteria, if any polymer is going to be get degraded, decomposed, then the obtained polymers are called as biodegradable polymers. Just once again, now the statement is, any polymer which can be degraded by the biological specimens due to natural activity. We are not doing anything, just due to natural activity. If any polymer is going to be get degraded or decomposed with the help of any biological species like bacteria, then such polymers are called as biodegradable polymers. Yes. Nowadays, if any person is met with an accident, and his bone is fractured, then when he went to the hospital for the treatment, to set the bone, doctors are using the polymers that are the biodegradable polymers. That means some type of equipments, metal, that is a metal plates like materials, they are fitted to support the broken bone. Some metal sheet like materials are put beside of the broken bones, and after the completion of operation, after 1 month or 2 months, within the body, the plates, they themselves get decomposed, because our body is containing so many bacteria, so many biological species. So with the help of any biological species, if any polymer get decomposed itself, such polymers are called as biodegradable polymers. Yes, in the textbook, in your textbook, at the end of this chapter, you can find examples for biodegradable polymers. First one is PHBB. PHBB means poly beta hydroxy butyrate. Poly beta hydroxy butyrate. Co beta hydroxy valerate. Once again, the word PHBB means poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. Just wait a minute, I will open the textbook. You can easily understand. And the second example given is nylon 2, nylon 6. These two are the examples given in your NCERT class 12 chemistry textbook at the end of the chapter polymers. So the two examples given for the biodegradable polymers are PHBV and nylon 2, nylon 6. Yes, nylon 2, nylon 6. If you see here the number 2, here the number 6. One monomer, first monomer is containing two carbons. Second monomer is containing six carbons. Just now I am going to share the screen. There you can easily understand what is the PHBV, what is nylon 2, nylon 6. Yes, at the end of the chapter, in the textbook, at the end of the chapter, yes, somebody is texting. Okay, fine. So at the end of this chapter in your textbook, you can find this one. Biodegradable polymers. This is the topic. Just once you read this one, you can understand the total concept given there. Yes, see this one. Poly beta hydroxy butyrate. Co means it is a copolymer. Here CO means it is not cobalt. It is not carbon monoxide. Here CO is given. That CO is not standing for carbon monoxide. It is not standing for cobalt. It stands for a copolymer. Here CO stands for PHBV is a copolymer. Yes, once text me whether the page is shared to you, whether the textbook is shared to you. My dear students, please text me. Is the sharing is obtained to you or not? Okay, fine. Yes, just read this one. Okay, so PHBV means poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. It is a copolymer. Okay, fine. And you can read the word, you can understand the word ATE. ATE means it is an ester. So esters are formed by the reaction of carboxylic acids with alcohols. Once again, esters are formed by the reaction of carboxylic acids with alcohols. In the last class, I also explained the same thing. When the carboxylic acids are going to react with alcohols, the obtained compounds are called as esters, and the process is called as esterification. So simply here you can understand that by just reading that word, poly beta hydroxy butyrate, it is indicating it is an ester. So PHBV is an example of PHBV is an example of polyester because it is containing the word it is indicating that is an ester. Okay, fine. And how many types of monomers are there? Two types of monomers are there. The first monomer is, yes, see the first monomer, PHBV, the first monomer is 3-hydroxy butanoic acid, 3-hydroxy butanoic acid, and the second monomer is 3-hydroxy pentanoic acid. 3-hydroxy pentanoic acid. 3-hydroxy butanoic acid and 3-hydroxy pentanoic acid are the two different types of monomers present in PHBV. Yes, I'm going to explain this formation. It is an important topic. So first of all, I have to take 3-hydroxy. Yes, just a minute. First of all, I am taking the 3-hydroxy butanoic acid. 3-hydroxy butanoic acid. That is represented as 3-hydroxy butanoic acid. Is it visible? Okay. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon, butyric acid. 1, 2, 3, 4 carbons are there. That is bute N. Third carbon having OH group, 3-hydroxy. COOH is there. That is called as oic acid. So the compound is named as 3-hydroxybutyric acid. And it is reacting with 3-hydroxypentoic acid. 3-hydroxypentoic acid. Same. After this one, it is common. First carbon, second carbon, third carbon. Here also, first carbon, second carbon, third carbon. After this one, it is common. Pentoic acid means it is containing 5 carbons totally in the chain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons in the chain. This is named as 3-hydroxypentoic acid. According to carboxylic acids topic, pentoic acid is called as valeric acid. Valeric acid. Pentoic acid, the common name of pentoic acid is valeric acid. So we can say that the common name 3-hydroxy valeric acid, and it is commonly known as butyric acid or butyric acid. So the common name of this compound is 3-hydroxy butyric acid. So you have to remember both common names as well as IUPAC names. So these two are the different monomers present in PHBB, poly beta hydroxy butyrate, co beta hydroxy valerate, where you can see there's a OH group. OH group means alcohol group is there. Of course, here COOH group is present. COOH group is known as carboxylic acid group. So whenever two different types of functional groups are there in the monomers, then the process of polymerization is called as copolymerization. So finally, we are going to get the polymer, that is a PHBB. Now we can say that PHBB is an example of copolymer. PHBB is an example of polyester, and PHBB is an example of biodegradable polymer. So that is all about PHBB. Yes, one more example is there. Nylon 2, nylon 6. I'm sharing the screen. First, see the text. Nylon 2, nylon 6. Yes, once you see this right side. PHBB, this is the final structure of PHBB. Of course, it is not for PO level examination. So no need to remember all those structures. No need to remember the PHBB structure. Just you have to understand C double bond O, single bond O is given. C double bond O. Yes, I'm going to highlight that one. See here, C double bond O, single bond O group is present. This group is indicating that this is the ester group. Ester group. How many times it is? Taken N times. That means poly. COO is called as ester. So by observing this structure, we can understand that PHBB is an example of polyester, right? And one more example, nylon 2, nylon 6. Let's see this one, nylon 2, nylon 6. In the biomolecules chapter, we studied about amino acids or amino acids. Amino means NH2 group, acid means COOH group. So see this one, amino caproic acid formula, NH2, CH2 taken 5 times, COOH, amino caproic acid or amino caproic acid, NH2, CH2 taken 5 times, COOH. So this amino caproic acid is containing amine group as well as carboxylic acid group. If one molecule is having both amine group and carboxylic acid group, such compounds are called as amino acids. So amino caproic acid is an example of amino acid. This is the structure. And the second monomer is glycine. Glycine. The formula of glycine is NH2, single bond CH2, single bond COOH. So in the glycine, on the left side, NH2 group is there, amine group is there. On the right side, COOH, carboxylic acid group is there. If any molecule having both amine group and carboxylic acid group, such compounds are called as amino acids. So nylon 2, nylon 6 is a copolymer, of glycine and amino caproic acid, and both are the examples of amino acids. Then the obtained polymer, nylon 2, nylon 6, is an example of polyamide. Polyamide, right? So here you can see the structure. Of course, here structure is not given. No need to consider. So nylon 2, nylon 6, it is an example of, yes, here it is given already, polyamide. Because from the NH2 group, hydrogen is going to be removed, H is going to be removed. From the COOH group, OH is going to be removed. That means water molecule is going to be removed. When a monomer or two different types of monomers are containing two different types of functional groups, then the polymerization is called as copolymerization. So now we can say that nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of, text me your answer. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of, text me your answer in the chat box. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of which type of polymer? Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of which type of polymer? Yes, text me your answer. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of which type of polymer? First of all, it is a copolymer because it is containing two different types of monomer units. And it is containing two different types of functional groups. Hence, it is an example of condensation polymer. And one more thing. It is an example of polyamide. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of polyamide. And one more thing. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of biodegradable polymer. So finally we can say that nylon 2, nylon 6 is an example of copolymer, condensation polymer. Next, polyamide and biodegradable polymer. So this is all about today's class. The time is very less. Remaining problems you have to solve. If you have any doubt, just you have to call me on my WhatsApp number 9490283667. Yes, text me your response about the class. The time is less. Text me your response. Whether the class is understood or not. Text me your response. All the students must text your response. Please pay your first